Some days ago, I got a very nice question from an engineer to connect two rectangular tubes in IdeaStatica. They are perpendicular one to the another, and they are connected with a small another tube, like a shoe. So first, I try to draw the connection, a small sketch first with light gray color, and then I will fill it. So this one, and in this tube there is another smaller tube. So this is our sketch. This one. Okay, so what we have? We have a thick tube, horizontal. On this horizontal tube, we will weld another short, a little bit smaller tube. So, and in this small tube, we will put a third smaller tube in it, and they will be connected with one weld, and this is one bolt, and this is connected with one weld. So from the front side, the horizontal one, the vertical shoe, and in this shoe we have our beam, which we have to connect with these bolts and these welds. What is our goal? We have to create this stiffening member. So you have to use a stiffening member and not the standard member. Standard member is used to, they are loaded. These are members you want to connect, but members you use for connection of these loaded members are stiffening members. So you have to use it from the operations. And then we will cut this. This is very simple. This is also a cut without welds. Then one bolt with four webs, 1, 2, 3, and 4 webs. The bolts creates automatically the contact surface between the webs. And then we will also add some contact area on both webs on the side. So I go to IdeaStatica, start an empty connection, and create first the horizontal tube and the vertical one, which we want to connect. Then some example loads, because I don't know the loads. I got only the question with a small sketch. So we will create a rectangular tube, square hollow section, for example, 150, 150 to 10 or something bigger. It's horizontal, but it's not ended, it's continuous. So we have to go through. This is, for example, not welded, so we can have the supports on both sides because the loads are not in equilibrium. If you have loads in equilibrium, you have support only on one side if you have a continuous member. The second member is the vertical one, and we have to select something smaller. I will select something about 80 millimeters. Again, square hollow section, 80, I don't know, 5. Important is this outer distance, this 80 millimeters. And it should be ended and rotated, so we can go to transparent and rotate it around 90 degrees. Okay. So these two members I have to connect. First load, create a new load. With vertical force of, I say, minus 20 and shear force 10 and 10 kilonewtons. Then the operations. So first I start with the most important part, and this is this stiffening member. Stiffening member is a beam which is used to transfer forces between two members. They get loads. So the width and height which have to be, or this inner width and height must be more than 80 millimeters. So I will select something about 90 millimeters. Where is it? 90, 3.6. I could select 1995, then we will get 80 millimeters, but you cannot put an 80 millimeter tube in the 80 millimeter diameter because you are not sure about the tolerances. So you need a little bit gap, I think. So we have to rotate it. It should be vertical, so around y-axis, 90 millimeters, and then we have to look on the heights. So I will try to change this to zero, okay, and this maybe to 200 millimeters. If you use higher height, then you have more capacity for the bending moment, if you have some bending moment. So this is 100, this is 75 millimeters, so we have 135 millimeter height. And I have to cut this stiffening member. I will change the name to shoe. Right mouse button, new operation is this cut. So I will cut shoe on M1. That's okay. On rectangular tubes, all these parts are webs, so we don't need weld on flange. We need, you can look on solid, we need these webs, but this is a fillet weld on both sides, so we need it only on one side. So you have to try this one. This is okay, this one is not okay, this is on the inner side, so we need this one. Okay, this is already welded. What we need is to cut this member if the height is not correct. So I go to transparent, the height is not correct. So I create a new cut and I will cut the M2 on M1 without welds and with an offset of 5 millimeters, so to have a small gap. And now we have to create these bolts. Right mouse button, new operation, bolt grid. With 8.8, 12 millimeters, that's enough for us. It's a small connection. So, and what we have to weld together. So I can put off these arrows. We have to connect 1, 2, 3, 4 plates. So I have to write 4 plates. All these plates are members, not plates. And now if you don't know the name, you see the name on the left bottom corner of the screen. If you hover on this plate, then it's shoe web 1. But if you don't remember the names, there is this arrow, so you can click on the plate and the second one and the third one and the fourth one. So, and we connect all these 4 plates with 1 bolt. And that's okay. We only have to change the height to, I would say, minus 65 millimeters. That's great. And already we have a contact area between these 2 plates and also on the opposite side. What we need is contact area between these 4 plates. So in contact area, you can create again with the bolt grid and simply change the bolts here to contacts. And we connect 2 parts, both are from members, and then you can select the first and the second plate of the member. You see this red rectangle, this is this is contact surface. So I have to rotate it. And I can copy it and change it. This is the bolt 4, so we have to use on the opposite side web 2, M2, web 2, and this is already connected. So that's all what you have to do. It's simple, only few operations, and then you can simply calculate it. Oh, there are no loads. Yes, okay. Yeah, I have put it enough. I will explain then the member type, what influence it have on this connection. This member type M2 is standard frame member, which can get shear force, axial force, and bending moments. So on this end, it's not supported. So if you input shear force, then this shear force by transformation of the forces, you can look on it. You go to wireframe and you see this shear force of 10 kilonewtons was transformed from this point to this point, and it creates bending moment. But we want to have bending moment zero. So that means this shear force times the length of the member have to be reduced from the bending moment. So it's inputted as a negative bending moment in our connection. You can look on the theoretical background, there is explain it. So, but we don't have on the top of our member some support, so we have the full bending moment on the end of the member. I would say I could change the position of the force to this bolt rows. This would be correct. So forces in. I don't know if it will work, because usually. Oh yes. Mm-hmm. So then we have the zero bending moment in these bolts. So, or you can change the position of the bending or of the forces to some distance which you want to define. So that's the first one. What we can do, then our utilization will change. I will wait a few seconds. This is nonlinear calculation, so it's everything iterative. It's nonlinear, it's plastic and also geometrical. So it's physical and geometrical nonlinear analysis. So we have a reduced utilization now, because we have smaller bending moments. And if you decide this is only a truss member, which can get only shear forces and axial force, no bending moment, then you can change the model type to truss member, only shear force and axial shear forces and axial force. Then Idea Statica put on the end support which will fix the rotation, so it can only move a little bit. So, and now if you calculate it, you get much less utilization. Maybe also quicker calculation, don't know. Okay, oh, it's some utilization. So, and then you can go to check, look on the stresses and strain. The strain is the plastic strain. This is the plastic part of the membrane strain. So these are stresses, strain. What you see is also, so you see this is not, there is a little bit in plastic branch of the stress strain diagram, but you see also contact. And then you see where you have contact between these two plates and where not. So I think that's all for the demonstration. It was about geometry, that you know how you can input geometry of such connection. I hope you enjoyed the video, and maybe you look on the next one. Thank you very much.